Do you know, our preamble is also known as the political horoscope. So, hey everyone, I am Parashi Sharma. Currently, I am working as an intern with LexClick & Company, and today I am going to talk about the topic preamble. So, preamble is like a identity card of our Indian constitution. And I am not saying this. A very famous social activist and jurist called it, whose name is N.A. Palkhivala. So, it is also known as the summary of our Indian constitution. The preamble of our constitution reflects the basic structure and features of Indian society and government. So, it highlights the type and features of our government, and preamble is not justifiable. But no law can be enacted in such a manner that it violates the spirit of our Indian constitution. The preamble of our constitution is inspired by objective resolution, and objective resolution was introduced by Jawaharlal Nehru, and this was later adopted by Constituent Assembly. The preamble has been amended only once so far, which is at the time of Indira Gandhi government in 1976. In that 42nd Amendment Act of 1976, Indira Gandhi added three words to preamble, which was socialist, secular, and integrity. So, our first part of our Indian preamble starts from "We the people of India," which shows that the source of authority is people of India. Then it talks about the nature of Indian state, which is sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, and republic. Then it talks about the objective of our Indian constitution, which is justice, liberty, equality, and fraternity. And then it talks about the date of adoption, which is 26th of November 1949, and then acceptance. So the idea of justice, social, economic, and political have been taken from the Russian Revolution of 1917, and the idea of liberty, equality, fraternity was taken from French Revolution, which was going on since 1789 to 1799. So let's talk in brief about the words which are in the preamble of our India. First word is sovereign. So sovereign means free from external control, that India has full authority to decide over its internal and external matters. Yes, India is a member of Commonwealth and United Nations, but the decision of Commonwealth and United Nations is not binding on India. That's why it does not affect the sovereignty of India, and our India is a sovereign state. Next term is socialist. So our India follows democratic socialism. There are two types of socialism. First is democratic socialism, and second is communistic socialism. So democratic socialism means it is a socialism in which both public and private sector coexist, which means a mixed economy. But in communistic socialism, it is also known as the state socialism. In communistic socialism, there is a nationalization of all means of production and distribution, and also the abolition of private property. Indian socialism is a democratic socialism, and socialism aims to end poverty, ignorance, disease, and inequality of opportunity. Indian socialism is a combination of Gandhian and Marxist ideology. So next word is secular. We already know that what secularism means. Secularism means that our country India does not have any official religion, but it values all religion. Every citizen of India can follow the religion of his or her own choice. And the word secular was added through the 42nd Amendment of 1976. And in our fundamental rights, Articles 25 to 28 talks about the freedom of religion. So next word is democratic. So there are two types of democracy, direct democracy and indirect democracy. Direct democracy means that in which people directly govern the state. But in case of India, due to such a high population, huge population, this is not a practical solution. So our democracy is an indirect democracy in which representatives of people rule over the country. And indirect democracy is further divided into two types, which is parliamentary and presidential. And we have parliamentary form of democracy. So our India has indirect parliamentary democracy. Next word is republic. Republic means that the law and constitution is the king. No one is the king except law and constitution. This in this, the head of the state is directly or indirectly elected for a fixed period of time. So sovereignty remains in the hand of people and not in the hands of king, and all public offices are open to every citizen without any discrimination. Next term is justice. Justice means security of fundamental rights and directive principles. And there are three types of justice: social justice, economic justice, and political justice. Social justice means equal treatment of all citizens without any social discrimination, like which is based on caste, color, sex, race, and religion. Next is economic justice. Economic justice is no discrimination on the basis of economic factors like wealth, income, property, etc. And next one is political justice. Political justice means that all citizens have a equal political right, equal access to political office, and equal voice to government. And combination of social justice and economic justice is known as distributive justice. So next term is liberty. Liberty means absence of restraints on the activities of individual, and the same time providing opportunity of development of individual personality. Liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith, and worship are enforceable in the court of law in case of violation. Whereas liberty does not mean it is a license that we can do everything. It is not a license. Liberty is up to a certain limitation, and we have to follow that limitations. Next is equality. Equality means treatment of all citizens in same way. Situation in which everyone has same rights and advantages, it indicates fairness. Next is fraternity. Fraternity means sense of brotherhood. It promotes mutual harmony in country. Constitution promotes fraternity by system of single citizenship. That's why we all feel like that we are Indian. We are not Marathi. We are not a Bihari. We all are Indian. So Article 51A says that it is a duty of every citizen of India to promote harmony and spirit of common brotherhood among all people of India, transcending religion, religious, linguistic, and regional and sectional diversities. And some case laws related to these are Berubari case of 1960, in which it was decided that preamble is not a part of our Indian constitution. But in Keshav Nanda Bharti case, preamble is declared as the integral part of our Indian constitution. Thanks for listening. Thank you.